If you see this message right now in your WordPress website, don't worry. In this calm and step-by-step tutorial, I'm going to help you to pinpoint the exact problems inside of your website so you can fix it and your website will be up and running in no time. Please check your site admin email inbox for instructions. If you don't get this email, no problem. In just a few minutes, I'm going to show you how to troubleshoot the problem without this email. So don't worry. If you do have this email, it looks something like this. This is a Dutch email because this is a Dutch website. It will be in your language. In there, you will find three links. The normal link of your website, the link to login, and then the last link inside of it is enter recovery mode with a token. This link will only be valid for just one day. So if we click on this link, as you can see, it's now possible for me to log into my WordPress website. So that's one step further. In this case, we can see a lot of information at why the critical error has been there. For example, one of more plugins failed to load properly. One of more themes failed to load properly. The theme you're using is using the deprecated WP title function, which prevents Buzz SEO from generating the correct titles. So it seems like we have a conflict with plugins and themes. Now, no matter what problems you encounter in your WordPress website right now, the very first thing you do is you go over here to updates, click on it, and then you scroll down and you make sure that everything has been updated. In our case, our plugins are up to date, our themes are up to date, but only our translations. Most of the time, your plugins or your themes has to be updated and then your problem might just dissolve. In our case, that is not the situation here. If you cannot log in because you didn't receive any email from the recovery mode or recovery mode doesn't work somehow, then I'm going to show you how we can fix this problem without logging into your WordPress website. For us to fix our website, we need to log into our hosting company. Now, this website is hosted on SiteGround, not the cheapest, but it has excellent support and it works like a charm. But no matter what hosting you're on, before we go into troubleshoot anything, you can always put back a backup of your website as the day before the problem started. In SiteGround, it is with security and you go to backups. In the backups, you can scroll down and just look for the backup that your hosting company has created. With a good hosting company like Hostinger, which I personally recommend, or SiteGround, which is also really good, a backup will be created every single night. So you can just put back the backup from where you are, press on restore all files and database, and then test if your website is still working. Of course, I can do this and I'm 100% sure that the website will work again as it still worked yesterday. But what kind of tutorial would that be? How to put back your backup? So we're not going to do that one because that is the easiest way. For now, you go back to your dashboard. We need to go to some place called File Manager. If you go into here, we are now at public HTML of this website. You need to find a place where you can see WP admin content and includes and all these PHP files, which are from your WordPress installation. The first thing you go is to go to WP content. Then from WP content, we go into here to themes. Click on it. Then you can see a couple of names. For example, this theme is called Jupiter, has been modified since 2020. That might be the cause of our problems right here because WordPress updates, but this theme, it looks like an abandoned theme. I don't know. And you have to look for this theme, 2024. It is a theme official by WordPress. And we're going to test if the theme is the problem. How to do that? First, you got to make sure that you have 2024 on your website. How to do that? Well, it's very simple. Just go to Google and type in download 2024 theme. And then we need to click on a result called WordPress.org, not WordPress.com. It's very confusing. I know they really have to fix it someday. I don't know if they ever will, but WordPress.org. Just click on this and here we can download it. So press download and then it has been downloaded to our PC. Then in your file manager, we just press up here on file upload, select the 2024, press open, and then it's been uploaded as a zip file. No problem at all. Just click on this zip file. And then we search for in this bar something like extract. There it is. Click on it. Extracted archive is success. Okay. Then we go into here and we see that it is just put it in this folder, which is wrong. So double click on it. We need this folder to go into the themes folder. So select this folder. Then we click on this move button. There's something in your hosting company, I'm sure. Click on it. make sure this is in this bar, so after public HTML, or maybe just you only see WP content slash themes. It's everything you need to see. Then press confirm. Now, in my case, the file already exists because I already had the theme. In your case, it might just copy and it's okay. If you see this, just press overwrite. All right, here we go. Go back to your themes. We can delete this one and this one because those are just double. So press delete. Okay, now we are sure that 2024 has been installed correctly. Go to your original theme that is active right now. If you have multiple themes, like 2024, 2023, 2022, then you only need 2024. And the other theme could be called Hello, could be called Divi, could be called Astra, something else. Just click on it, then click on Rename, and then you just type in broken behind the name and press Confirm. Now, this will force WordPress to use the standard theme 2024 on your website. And this way, we can see if the theme is actually the problem here. Now, once you have done this, go to your website, copy it. We can see now the white screen of death. This means that the theme is not 100% the problem, because if it was the problem, then I can now see my website with a different layout, but I don't see my website at all. Now you have learned one thing, the theme is not the entire problem. So we go back to here, just remove the broken and give it the back the original name and press confirm. Close the themes, then go over here to plugins. It might be that one of these plugins is actually the problem. How to find this? Well, you just click on one, press on rename. We're going to change this to broken and press confirm. You can do this with a couple of plugins at the same time. So really quick, as you can see right now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 plugins renamed. Go back and test your website. Nothing has changed for me. It's still the critical error on this website. Then we just go back to our WordPress installation and we continue with the next 5 to rename them. Then again, I just renamed a couple more. Let's see if it worked right now. Nothing has changed, still a critical error. Okay, I have now renamed all my plugins. So when the problem is caused by a plugin, it should be fixed right now. It's impossible that my problem still exists now if a plugin is the actual cause of all the problems. In this case, the problem still exists. Now I'm starting to get a little bit worried because this means that no plugin is the cause of it, but it might be a combination of the theme because it's still on. So I'm also going to rename the theme now again and see what's going on here. Ah, so now I get a white screen. This means that there lies a problem inside of the theme. When you see this, you might be able to log into your WordPress website and continue from there. So let's try that. Type in WP admin after your URL and press enter. Ah, yes, some success. We can now log into our WordPress website. That's way better than what we had before when not trying to log in. The first thing what we see is no plugins has been activated because I've renamed all of them. No worries, we're gonna put them back. But the first thing we need to do is go over here to updates. Very important. Click on it. What you can see right now is that we have one plugin that might be the cause of our problems. I don't think so, but it is possible. Make sure to put all your updates that you see in here to do them right now. Also the theme updates and maybe some translation updates. Do every update right now before we activate all your plugins again. So just update plugins. Then we wait a little bit. Update successful. Then we go back to our hosting company. And while we are logged in, we can change everything back. So we go to our theme, rename it to the original name and press confirm. Also do the same with all the plugins. Going to rename all of them back to their normal names. Personally, I would never create such a website. 3 plugins for just one form. I would just replace this with Gravity Forms, you know, login logo editor, logo translate. I don't think you actually need those. JS Composer theme, that sounds like WP Bakery Builder. I'm not a fan of this one, but I didn't build this website, so let's go. And also WP Super Cache, also a plugin I would never advise you to use. Now, while we are still logged into our website, we just need to refresh it to see what's going on. What I hope to achieve now is when I refresh my WordPress admin environment, I will see some troubles coming up while we are logged in. I don't hope we get the widescreen of that, or else we cannot see anything in our WordPress admin, and that would be a bummer. So press on home, critical error on our website. That's too bad. All right, but we are still locked into the system. All right, I've just renamed the theme again back to broken. Let's see if that does the job. So the current status, all plugins activated, updated, theme disabled. Let's see what happens when I press F5 on my keyboard. I don't think anything is happening. We still have critical error on our website. Okay, so this asks for a more thorough approach. We go back to our plugins, and then again, we're going to rename them all back to broken, and then we're going to enable them one by one while our theme is being disabled. All right, I've just disabled a few plugins. Let's press F5 on my keyboard. So yes, we are in. Now we can see that solid security features, that could not be the problem. The theme you are using is using the depreciated WP title functions. Now we can go to plugins, install plugin. Now we can see a couple of more problems because I deactivated those three. So now we can actually see that the problem lies with Buzz SEO. And I'm just going to activate the other plugins that I think might not be broken. So WP Supercache, for example, press confirm. Then we have only GS Composer theme is broken. And Buzz SEO. I don't know Buzz SEO, really. And then we just have to go with trial and error. So I leave the theme as in broken. Then I go back to my website and press F5. And when all is good, okay, Buzz SEO has been deactivated. Now, can I now see my website? Open it in a new tab. No, because of the theme. Okay, no problem at all. We go to appearance, themes. We can see that the Jupyter theme is in here, but it has been deactivated because I renamed it. So we go back to site tools, we go to our themes, and I'm going to rename the Jupyter theme back to normal. Now, if what I think is correct, the whole website will shut down again. Let me see, refresh this page. There has been a critical error. Okay, took us a little bit of time, but now you know the problem lies with the combination of our theme, Jupyter, Buzz SEO, and I think, let's go back to plugins, and I also think this one, the GS Composer theme. Well, to make that sure, just activate this one, Buzz SEO, activate also the Buzz SEO. Now we've activated all plugins again. We go back to our themes. Here we go. Broken. Confirm. If I now can log in into my, yes, so I'm now inside of this WordPress installation of this website. And let's also do this one right now. Close this one and put this on manual. Check IP, that's okay, and press save. But solid security can break your website, but in this case, I don't think it's the cause of all our problems. So this problem has been caused by the theme Jupyter. So what do we need to do? We need to update this theme. Jupyter version 5.7 by ArtBees. I have never heard of them. So what do we do is we go to google.com, we type in Jupyter theme, and then we have, hey, we have ArtBees over there with a changelog. Now this is interesting. I didn't build this website, so I think it's this one, version 6.12. Now we were on the Jupyter theme version 5.7. We need to buy the Jupyter WordPress theme again to update all these things that might be causing a critical error. If you want to buy the legacy version of Jupyter, you have to buy a license for the Jupyter X. Interested in Jupyter instead of Jupyter X, by purchasing, you also get its legacy version. So that's what I'm gonna do. Then I've downloaded from ThemeForest, Jupyter main package. Finally, I have the new theme and also the plugin GS Composer theme, which we need for the website. I go to my website, I go to appearance, go to themes, go to add a new theme, upload it. I'm going to select Jupyter version 6, open it and press install now. Now, when all is good, it will say you already have one. Here we are, active. And the uploaded version is this one. Do you want this? I press yes, replace active with uploaded. There we go. Then we also go to plugins, add new plugin. And I'm going to upload this one, the GS Composer theme, and press install now. Yes, I want to replace it, activate plugin. Fingers crossed, I hope when I go to themes, activate Jupyter 6. That's why, no, this is one of the reasons why I don't like themes from ThemeForest. So we also need to Jupyter Core and Jupyter Donut for this website. Well, let me see if I actually need it or if this just does the job. Just open it in an incognito screen. Okay, here we are. It looks okay, but we're missing some things. So let's make sure that we also have these Jupyter Core and Jupyter Donut. Upload plugin. Select this Jupyter Core. Here we go. Install it. Activate it. And let's also go with Jupyter Donut. Install now. All right. Activate plugin. Then we have this one, Contact Form 7, Layer Slider, Master Slider, WooCommerce. I don't want all these things. Just dismiss this notice. Also close this one and activate the Buzz SEO. Oh, we also have this old version still. Let's delete this one and activate WP Super Cache. Let's see if the website now works. This actually looks like things are working again. All right, put back the main menu. And then finally, the website works again. Let's see if the pages work. Really great. All right, everything works again. What do we learn from this? Always do your updates and use a real page builder like Elementor Pro or Divi. Trust me, those are the two. If you want to know which one I advise, follow this tutorial.